हेलो गाइस, दिस इज रेवंस फ्रॉम डीजी इंटीग्रिटी। वेलकम टू टेक न्यूज एपिसोड 43। सैमसंग गैलेक्सी F12 एंड सैमसंग गैलेक्सी F02 हैज बीन लॉन्च्ड इन इंडिया। लेट्स सी सम ऑफ द स्पेसिफिकेशंस ऑफ बोथ दिस मोबाइल। सैमसंग गैलेक्सी F12 कम्स विद अ 6.5 इंच HD+ 90Hz डिस्प्ले एंड इट रन्स ऑन एक्सिनोस 850 प्रोसेसर एंड इट कम्स विद अ 48 मेगापिक्सल क्वाड रियर कैमरास। And if we see about the battery, it comes with a 6000 mAh battery with 15 watt fast charging. Now let's see about the specifications of Samsung Galaxy F02s. It also comes with 6.5 inch HD+ display and it runs on Snapdragon 450 processor. It comes with a 13 megapixel triple camera and the battery is about 5000 mAh and it comes with 15 watt fast charging. Now let's see about the prices and the storage variants. Samsung Galaxy F12 has an introductory price in India of ₹10,000 for the 4GB or 64GB storage model and ₹10,999 for the 4GB and 128GB storage. This also includes a ₹1,000 from an instant discount through the ICICI Bank credit and EMI transaction. It will be available in celestial black, sky blue and sea green colors. Samsung Galaxy F12 sale in India starts on April 12th at 12 noon on Flipkart and Samsung's official website. Samsung Galaxy F02 price is ₹8,999 for the 3GB and 32GB model and ₹9,999 for the 4GB RAM and 64GB storage. It comes in black, white and blue color option. Both the phones will be available via Flipkart and Samsung website. This phone will go on sale from starting April 9th at 12 noon. OnePlus is currently evaluating always-on display for OnePlus Watch. The upcoming OTA update will allow users to customize the preset reply list. OnePlus Watch specifications include a 1.39-inch AMOLED display, 402mAh battery and an IP68 rating. OnePlus Watch price in India is ₹14,999 and the smartwatch will go on sale soon. OnePlus Pay India launch could be imminent, trademarks feeling suggest. OnePlus Pay is an NFC-based mobile payment service that will make take on Google Pay, Samsung Pay and others. This payment service is currently available only in China. In August last year, Google rolled out Google Meet, Chat and Rooms tabs in Gmail for G Suite customers. This added new tabs to the Gmail interface, making it easier to users to stay in touch with their colleagues and collaborate on tasks. Google is now extending the integration to personal accounts and giving all user access to the new chat and the room tabs. Facebook is back in the limelight for all the wrong reasons, and in this time the new report claims that personal data of over 533 million users have surfed on the hacker forum. The database appears to be the same set of Facebook linked telephone numbers that has been circulating in hacker circles since January and whose existence was first exposed by Alon Gil, who is the co-founder of Israel cybercrime intelligence firm Hudson Rock. But Facebook is claiming that the data was very old and it is related to an issue that it had fixed on August 2019, and nearly 6 million Indian Facebook users' data have been compromised. Tecno Spark 7 smartphone will be made official this week. As expected, a landing page of smartphone has appeared on Amazon India. The listing has confirmed that the Spark 7 will be made official on April 9th in India. The Spark 7 is packed with a massive 6000 mAh battery that can last up to 41 days. It is expected to carry a support for fast charging as its predecessor model featured it. Tecno is yet to reveal the other specifications of the smartphone. ByteDance, a parent company of the popular short video social media platform TikTok, has told the Indian court that the freeze on its bank account in the country by the government amounts to harassment. As per the court filing, the Chinese giant says that the freeze on its bank account in a probe of possible tax evasion amounts to harassment was done illegally. India's Tax Intelligence Unit ordered HSBC and Citibank in Mumbai to freeze bank accounts of ByteDance India as it probes some of the unit's financial dealings. Fortnite maker Epic Games to raise around $1.7 billion of funding through existing and new investors. With this, the valuation of the company will reach an estimated $28 billion. Pinterest has held talks to buy Visco, a photography app that swapped a teenage social media craze, according to two people with knowledge of the matter. The discussion are ongoing, said the people who declined to be identified because they were not authorized to speak publicly. The deal price couldn't be learned. Pinterest has a market capitalization of about $49 billion, while Visco has raised $90 million in funding and was last valued at $550 million. An acquisition may not materialize, the people cautioned. Oppo has been trying to offer different form factors for its device that has recently unveiled a couple of concepts with unique smartphone devices. In line with that, a Chinese company has now applied for a detachable device unit. The device indicated in this patent is a detachable device similar to the Microsoft Surface Book. LG may be planning to shut down its ailing smartphone business, but the brand is still a leading name in other aspects, one of which is the display segment. The Korean brand has just announced a new laptop packing its OBM display in the home market. The laptop is dubbed LG Ultra Gear 17 and it is a high-performance product. This laptop also packs with 11th generation Intel Core i5 processor paired with 8GB of DDR4 RAM. There is equally 512GB of SSD on board. Both the RAM and memory can be upgraded by users if they want using expansion slots. Noise has launched 3 true wireless earphones one after the other, the latest being the Noise Buds Play. The Buds Play features an interesting pebble-shaped design and also comes with 3 different color options. Noise Buds Play has been launched at an introductory price of ₹2,999. The earbuds also comes with a Google Fast Pairing technology and the company has claimed that it could go up to 25 hours on a single charge. However, soon after the offer gets over, the Buds Play could be sold at its original price of ₹3,499. Nokia is all set to launch a new audio product in India. The company has confirmed that it will launch an audio product on April 5th through a listing on Flipkart. Without revealing much about the audio product, the Nokia said that the upcoming device is designed to give a pure sound. And it can be concluded that Nokia is hinting towards launching a true wireless earphones that is water resistant. It may also comes with active noise cancellation and may come with a low latency rate. Realme has announced a launch of new true wireless earbuds, the Realme Buds A2 Neo on April 7th. As their name suggests, the true wireless earbuds are new version of the Realme Buds A2 that debuted in India on Feb 2021. Similar to the Buds A2, the upcoming Buds A2 Neo will feature active noise cancellation that essentially cancels out certain elements of ambient sound to provide a richer hearing experience. The new pair of earbuds will also feature 10mm dynamic bass boost audio drivers and can deliver a total of about 28 hours of audio playback. The earbuds are available in India at ₹1,799. In February, Realme launched the Narzo 30 Pro 5G and Narzo 30A smartphones. The company is likely to introduce the Realme Narzo 30 handset this month. It was recently confirmed by Realme CEO Madhav said that the Narzo 30 will be coming in 4G and 5G editions. This phone is going to be powered by Helio G95 and it runs on Android 11 OS and it will be coming with 6GB of RAM. In the single core test, the handset scores 517 points and it recorded a score of 1682 points in the multi-core test. Xiaomi has revealed a new poster on a new smartphone. Redmi 20X is now doing runs on Weido. The image has revealed its design, key specification and color edition. It is expected to replace the Redmi 10X 5G phone from last year. The Redmi 20X can be seen sporting a punch hole display and its rear camera setup has a triple camera setup with dual LED flash. Redmi 20X is a 5G ready handset which features a 90Hz display and its rear camera setup has a 48MP primary lens. The poster further reveals that it comes with 4GB of RAM and 128GB of internal storage. Realme launched the Realme 8 series in India on March 2021. That competes directly against the Redmi Note 10 series. Both Realme 8 Pro and Redmi Note 10 Pro features a 108MP camera but lacks 5G support. Now at least Realme has confirmed the development of 5G variants Realme 8 and 8 Pro that would launch very soon. Xiaomi has officially opened its newest Mi Home in China, located in the city of Shenyang. This store opens marks a milestone for the brand as it is the 5000th Mi Home store. Another interesting fact about this new store is that it is the first to wear the new Xiaomi logo. Lenovo has confirmed that the company will be launching its next generation gaming smartphone Lenovo Legion 2 at the launch event on April 8th in China. Now ahead of the official announcement, the company has been teasing the phone features. In the latest teaser, Lenovo has revealed that the smartphone is the world's first to come with dual turbo super liquid cooling technology with an integrated heat dissipation system to make sure that the device doesn't heat up under heavy usage. In the another teaser, the company also confirmed the camera configuration on the smartphone. It will come with a 64MP primary sensor on the back and it also supports 4K 120fps and 8K with 30fps video shooting. It is also confirmed that the upcoming flagship smartphone from Lenovo will come with 6.92-inch Full HD Plus AMOLED display and offers 144Hz refresh rate and a 720Hz touch sampling rate. Under the hood, the device will be powered by Qualcomm Snapdragon Triplet processor, which comes up to 16GB of RAM and 512GB of storage. The company also bumped the battery capacity from 5000mAh battery on the first gen model to 5500mAh battery. Hawaii is set to host a new product launch event in its home country, China, on April 8, where it is expected to launch a new V series smart screen 2021 device. For those who are unaware, Hawaii prefers to call its smart TV a smart screen. The upcoming 2021 models of the Hawaii Dewel V series smart screen features HDR Vivid display technology, which is jointly promoted by Tencent and a few other companies. Thanks for watching this video. Please kindly support my channel by giving a like, share and subscribe. And follow Digi Integrity on Twitter, Instagram and Facebook.